it.
Check, check, checking in on your boys. Welcome, welcome. You're now tuned in to the Eat, Pray, Ball podcast. As always, it's your boy, Matt Marshall, young American Chelsea fan from Atlanta, Georgia. And I'm here with some new blood. But let me introduce my typical co-host here. I got my boy, Juan Chan, straight out of California. Barcelona, Man City fan. I got the unmistakable George Blamo in the building, our Portuguese Ghanaian brother who's a Man United fan and always reps for Portugal. Our boy all the way out from Houston, Texas, living in Houston, Texas, got roots in Jamaica, roots in London, and is an Arsenal fan. Ash Austin's in the building. What's up, big dog? And as it has it, we have a new guest in the building. Yohei, what is good, brother? What's your last name, Yohei?
Yohei
Fiji. Yohei Fiji. Easy enough. Yohei, welcome in. You're going to have to kind of get close to Juan so we can hear you. But we love new guests here on the podcast because, you know, obviously this podcast is about bridging cultures. It's about the love of soccer. Everybody here I know on this podcast, because I've played with you playing soccer or we've bonded over some soccer thing. I met Ash. He went to school with me. I see you got the Howard. You repping the Howard sweatshirt. I met Ash and we bonded because we would go upstairs in our freshman dorm, drink vodka and orange juice and play FIFA all day. That shit was lit. So that's just what it's about here on this podcast. But Yohei, I want to know one, where you're from, why you fuck with soccer, and two, what your team is.
I'm originally from Japan, and then I played soccer since I was 6-7. So like, I love this sport. I only play soccer. I love any sports, but you know, since I have playing soccer a long time and I've been watching, so I love it. That's my sport. And my team is.
That's also George's second team, if you didn't know. That's how they do it out here. Madrid. How does it feel sitting next to a Barca fan, being so dope, being so tight with a Barca fan?
Right.
It doesn't affect you.
The Barca fan is sick.
Right. Wait, so when did you move to the States?
2011. So like 9 years ago.
Okay. Nice. And you found, and how did you find Juan, and how did you find like soccer out here?
Oh, actually, I was playing soccer at my college, and then he came with his friend, and we play soccer. I think summer, like summer vacation.
Yeah.
And we've been playing soccer like almost every day.
Bruh. Like, isn't that how it happens? Like, that's legit. Like, all it is, you just meet somebody and you're just like, oh shit, oh, you ball too? All right, let's go ball. Yeah.
Because he always wear that Barcelona jersey.
Yeah, dude.
Oh, that's that shit.
But here, right, like, not everyone plays soccer. So the second that someone talks to you about soccer, you're like, hey, like, you know what's up. Like,
it's that's real.
Such a small thing to be into here in America, right?
It's like a fraternity, right? Like, you know, you see somebody who likes it, you're almost automatically drawn to them. So I would say that, but I will also say, like, every time I go overseas and, like, talk to people who, you know, talk to anybody because everybody fucks with soccer overseas. Like, I naturally have that bond with them too. You know what I mean? It's interesting like that. Like, AJ and I went to England, a year and a half ago? 2 years ago now. And we pulled up in this cab. This guy was listening to some like sport talk radio and like they said something funny and we started laughing and he was like, oh, you know, like he naturally recognized us as Americans, but he was like, oh, you fuck with soccer? And we just started going off, you know, like we were like, yeah, you know, Arsenal is this right now. Chelsea is this. We're actually going to the Stamford Bridge right now to go visit. And he just like we talked to him like the whole ride. So, you know. Maybe that's just how sports are in general. You just kind of catch like a fraternity somehow, just feeling the energy or whatever. But speaking of energy, we out here, it's the last podcast of the year. And because of that, we're going to go kind of down the list of best of the year, even though this ain't been no kind of best year at all. So in true spirit, we were talking about this just off camera, and now that we're on tape, and now that we have a man for Japan, which has nothing to do with South Korea, we have to start with some of the best wingers that have come out this year. I don't even want to say come out this year because that's not true, but some of the best producing wingers this year. Again, we were talking about this off camera. Obviously, I'm talking about Heung-min Son. Where do you rank Heung-min Son in terms of attacking wingers? Give me top five. Does he rank even in your top five of attacking wingers this year?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. At his current form, yes.
At his current form. But like, and it's funny you say, because you said it, George, like, he's been in form for like 3 years straight. Like, straight up, like, you outside of those injuries, those ankle injuries or whatever, like, he's been in form.
So last year he had a couple, I don't know what was going on with him, but he had like a couple issues where he was going into tackles extremely hard. he broke what's his face's ankle, that bum. Andre Gomes. He's a bum anyway, so it doesn't really matter. But then, like, he just kept getting red cards, and it just didn't make sense why he was getting them.
He was getting yellow red cards.
And then his form last year wasn't to his normal status, but like the previous seasons and this year, he's back on the way he should be playing.
Bro, he's the best player at Tottenham right now. Is that real or is that facts or fiction?
Yo, if you say Harry Kane, you don't watch the game yet.
But here's the thing though, Harry Kane is still that guy. Like, it's not like he's not.
Yeah.
And again, I was telling George, like, I think Harry Kane's clout, a lot of Harry Kane's clout, even, I mean, he's a great player, but a lot of his clout comes from the fact that there's not a lot of players like him right now. There's not a lot of like number nine target / distributing / you know, like clinical scoring players out there right now. But and that like is almost the reason Son doesn't get that same clout, because everybody is an attacking winger. Like, you can think of Leroy Sané, you can think of Mane, Salah, Hazard, who, you know, like what, like Jadon Sancho, you can go a million.
Was a season for the past 4 years.
But so that, I guess that's the question. Yep. Like, outside of like Cristiano Ronaldo, you know, outside of, I mean, like, give me your top five. Give me your top five, like, attacking wingers. Right? Like, I mean, shit. Heung-min Son is definitely up there. Like, he's not number one.
Yeah, but I don't really consider him a winger, though.
I said this before. I think he's a second striker, dude.
I think he's, okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
I would give that. He kind of plays off the forward.
He plays off the forward.
Because he's not giving you winger-type service.
Well, I mean, when I say attacking winger, I'm talking about the modern, like, attacking winger, where nobody gives you winger-type service. If you're left-footed, you go on the right side so you can cut in and shoot. If you're right-footed, vice versa.
But he's not really – is he really switching the field when he's playing? He's kind of just hangs out on that left side.
Yeah, he camps out on that left side, and – I mean, what is Tottenham? Tottenham doesn't play a 4-4-2. Well, shit.
played a 4-4-2 last week.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, but I mean, again, but if you are that good of a player, typically the coach will allow you to do what you need to do.
Yeah, you just.
So if you are threatening, if you don't like the guy you're going up against and you want to switch sides, a lot of wingers do have that flexibility. But Son doesn't. I'm sure he could. He just seems to like his spot.
They have an outlet. Like, I don't know. I don't really even understand, because I low key think it's Kane who's serving him these balls.
He's always tracking back, and that's why I respect.
Yeah, he tracks back.
Hey,
too.
But he's doing that less, dude. He did that a lot last season. He got a lot of red cards, like reckless challenges, right? Like,
yeah.
I feel like this season he tracks back, and he's not going to the ground anymore. Like, he's not diving tackling.
Yeah, no, he's not. I think like maybe Mourinho had to say, bro, like, save that energy going forward, like, defensively, just get in front of the player or some shit like that. Like, cause that was wild. He definitely broke Andre Gomes' leg. It is working.
That was crazy.
It is working. And it works for Jose too, because that's Jose's formula, right? Like, we're going to sit back, absorb every bit of pressure and play defense for 90% of the game, only to spring our fast players who can like be clinical. And
this is a better team.
Did they deserve to beat Liverpool?
I don't know.
You gotta love my grandpa, yo. My grandpa funny, bro. You gotta let him live.
Oh my god. The best team won. You should have seen Klopp's face when he looked at Buddy's. Like, you could tell he said some shit to Klopp, because Klopp looked at him like, Like they came in for the hug and shit, and it was like, all right, all good. And you thought it was just like, good game, you know, catch you next time. But like Klopp was like, what? Okay. How does that work? Would you put Mane or Salah over Son right now?
Only Mane.
I don't want to hear this shit about Mane. Mane has zero goals. I'm sorry. He has two goals this year.
All right.
Salah? Yeah, right now? Salah's giving us tap-in.
Like, also penalties.
Salah's got like a couple more, but.
Yeah.
13 matches, 13 goals for Mohamed Salah. He's out here. He's out here.
For sure. Isn't he also their penalty taker, though?
Yeah, he's their penalty taker. But as we said, you missed this show, Juan. As we said, a penalty is a goal. And if you're Cristiano, you probably drew a goal.
A lot of the little jealous of Mane. Mane should be taking some of this. That's all I'm saying.
Man, Mane's got 5 goals in 13 matches.
Mane.
How many of those penalties that he converted for Salah to score?
Man, it don't matter. It don't matter. If you ain't the PK taker, you ain't the PK taker. Y'all, I mean, because on some real shit, like, you know, Klopp is like, you know, like anybody can go. You just have to fit the formula. I'm sure if in practice Mane was getting PKs in better than Salah, Mane would be taking these kicks. I'm actually surprised Firmino's not taking these kicks, or like Jordan Henderson is not taking these kicks.
Do you know that I saw there was a stat from this week. And it basically said that Salah is at like 0.97 goals per game, which is like the best forward ever,
right,
which is ahead of Henry at 0.96.
Oh, Premier League, like, so you get, overall?
Yes.
Shit.
He's apparently right now he's on pace. He is the best forward the Premier League has ever seen on return on goals. So you guys are still talking shit about this man?
That's crazy.
So I will.
That's crazy.
I just feel like when you watch the game, statistics, you're right. Statistically, you might be right. But my boy Mane is the reason that Liverpool is doing half the shit they're doing.
Like, see, that's why I love Mane.
On the left flank.
I'm going to be watching these games for real.
That's the beauty of the game. We can either money ball it, or we can talk about things that we think are
intangible,
you know, hard to quantify.
Right.
You know, basketball has like that. Basketball has a stat, right, where it's like efficiency, like assists,
yeah, efficiency touches, rating, like, yeah, per touch.
Yeah, like what is there an efficiency rating in the Prem? And if so, I'd like to see Mane's versus Salah's. Because I feel like Mane creatively, he does so much more for the team. Salah is
so much
on the other side. Like, what are Mane's? How many assists does Mane have this season? Could y'all look that up? Is that a thing?
We be fact checking here at Epray Ball.
We fact check everything, bro. We'll find that. Find that. Transfer Market is my favorite place to fact check, because their stats be up the second it happens.
Okay. And he hustled a lot. Like, he's done the whole game.
Yeah.
Giving assists, scored the goals.
Bro, Mane's got 3 assists, bro.
Oh, 3 assists. Damn.
All right.
I mean.
What about last year? Hold up. What about last year?
Man, what have you done for me lately? Not last year.
Last year, he was amazing.
Last season, he was amazing.
He scored so many goals.
He scored hella goals. Even though he was like tied with Salah. And so here's the thing I hear. Salah is selfish as fuck. Like, you can see it how he plays. So like, a lot of people don't even like his game that way.
What the fuck does that mean? Like,
I don't know when you've got 13 goals in 13 games.
He's scoring goals.
Right.
He's a ball hog.
He is a ball hog.
Who gives a fuck?
But when you look at the stats, and the stat that Ash just told us, like, for good reason, he's a ball hog. Like,
all right, yo, look. If, granted, right, Liverpool's been struggling, right?
More than they have last year. They're top of the Prem table, so I don't know how much.
But I'm just saying, they're not Liverpool right now.
Okay.
Because of their injuries from defenders and whatnot, right?
Yeah, yeah.
If you have a chance to score more goals and win more comfortably, pass the fucking ball. That's all I'm saying. That's literally all it takes.
That is true. Like,
I'll be honest. Like, Ronaldo in the beginning of his career was a ball hog. He was an extreme ball hog. Now he dishes the ball off to his teammates, bro.
I think that's really funny you say that, because I think Ronaldo is actually just more efficient with his ball hogging. He's not going to be a ball hog in the center of the pitch. He's going to give you the ball so that you can make sure you give it to somebody who will give it back to him when he's in the fucking box. Like, if Ronaldo's in the box, he is not passing the ball. So why should Salah?
I've seen it. He passes it, though. That's what I'm saying.
I mean, let's go to Ronaldo's assists for the year versus goals. I'm sure his stats will look a lot more like Salah's than Mane's.
Man, those stats are tough to equate back to the Premier League. I mean,
it is a different game.
Juventus should just be getting a lot of fucking goals.
Ronaldo has 0 assists, 12 goals in 9 games.
I mean, like, team goals. Who do you think has more goals, Liverpool or Juventus? They should play around the same amount of games, right?
Yeah, they have. I think Prem has played more games, but, you know, same. Prem.
Liverpool have 36 goals in 14 games.
Jesus.
Juve aren't top. 28 goals in 13 games.
I mean, that's pretty close.
And they're still undefeated, right?
Juventus?
Yeah.
Yeah, but
and Serie A players,
they've had 6 draws though, so they're third.
Damn, who's top? Milan's top, right?
Milan, yeah. Inter second.
Dude, like the real Serie A's kind of back, huh? AC, Inter, and Juve 1, 2, and 3. That ain't bad. Shit.
Roma, then Napoli,
and then Roma and Napoli. Like that's the Serie A we're used to. Yo, shout out, Chris.
Napoli for the fifth is normal.
Yeah, exactly. Napoli's typically like 2, 3, you know, around this time of year. I'm just saying.
Back to Liverpool.
You're right. I'm just saying. Sometimes you're a ball.
Robertson
hog.
Has the most assists at 5.
Oh yeah, that makes sense. I'm sure. And who's second? I'm sure it's fucking Alexander Arnold.
Firmino at 3.
Ooh. Okay. Yeah, I also have
so
to.
Clearly, they're just trying. They just need to get goals. Clearly, so that's why Salah is just taking shots.
I guess so. I do. I mean, but I know what you're saying. As it relates to the eye test, when you see Salah and he's running up the line and he just beat a player and he's running full speed and he cuts inside, like Mane is literally like standing alone in the box. But by that point, bro, like shooters shoot. You know, like it does. He looks like a ball hog when he misses. But when he busts that net, he's fucking, you know, he's the god of Liverpool. So I don't know. It is. It's 6-1, half a dozen another. So after hearing these stats, do y'all still say, and again, I'm kind of talking about year 2020. And obviously, you know, there's more stats from the previous year of 2020. We have more, you know, 2019, 2020 from this year than we do 2021. But. You know, would you still put Sané over Son?
Yeah. Mane over Son?
Mane, right?
Sané and Mane. Would you still put Mane over Son? Yeah.
Wait, like if you're choosing one?
Yeah. You got one player to bring on your team. You want Homan Son, who's got 11 goals this year in 13 games, or you want Mane, who's got 5 goals in 13 games.
Mane without a Salah?
It doesn't. Bro, if Cristiano came to.
I'm going to take Mane. But if Salah's on Mane's team, I'm going to take Son.
But in none of those situations, you would take Salah.
No.
Bro, you're wilding. This man has the most goals of the 3 players we're talking about. Who else? Hey, all right. Who else?
Like you said, this is the last podcast of the year, right? So let's see now. Let's see how he ends this season. Let's see.
Man, I think you're being racist against Africans. Salah is just been
coming. Oh, you're right. West African hating on the East African.
West Africans right. Hating on the East Africans. You feel me? I know that rivalry. I know how that shit goes. Top strikers. Top 5. Give me your top 5 strikers. Yohe. Off the top of your dome right now.
Right now?
Yeah, just give me your top 5. Who's been balling for you?
Lewandowski.
Okay. Lowy. 100%.
I guess I put Ronaldo.
Okay. Striker, right? I'll give you that. He's playing striker now. There's some debates about whether or not he's a striker, but I think he is.
I think he is now. Damn, top 5.
Damn, he can't even name 5 strikers. You see, the art of striking is just...
was out with Song, but Song is not striker. Or like, I mean, he is striker. No,
I call him a second striker.
I'll say he's a false nine.
Also not yet.
I don't want to hear that shit. I'm talking strikers. We've had many podcast episodes where I've explained to y'all that you a forward is not a striker and a striker is not a forward. Same. Like there, I'm talking. Y'all haven't even said Son's teammate.
Kane.
Right. Honey Kane.
And y'all are really killing me because
I have to put Honey Kane.
his is basically his clone at Leicester.
Right.
My son Vardy's nice though.
Yeah, Vardy's nice.
You feel me? Is Vardy
I just
top
don't
five?
Know if he's a top five.
Y'all are killing me that y'all haven't even mentioned
all right,
my boy
Ronaldo. I think Ibra. You have to put Ibra.
Oh yeah,
Ibra.
You have to put Ibra.
Yeah,
you
put for Ibra. Sure.
Lewandowski, obviously.
Okay. Ibra still is top five.
Right. That's
yeah,
crazy.
Yeah, I think. Yeah,
bro.
Look at both of them. Bold. Yeah.
I mean, he beat his save AC Milan. He came. He was playing for the Galaxy. He was doing well.
Come so back you're to going. You're,
AC is you're at the top Ibra of the table.
Hold on. You're going Ibra over Lukaku?
Oh, we've done this before.
Yeah. We've already gone down this
road. We've done
before.
This before.
I miss hitters. I like Lukaku. I wouldn't say he's top five. Bro, if Lukaku
wow.
Ibra is consistent, if Lukaku on a good day was consistent, this would not be a debate at all.
Did you just say if Lukaku was consistent?
Yeah.
What? Lukaku was only not consistent at Man United. Bro, I hope you're Googling Lukaku's stats.
Like that.
Are we talking about this long-term career? Like, what are we talking about?
Chelsea.
Bro, Lukaku's number two in goals.
In Inter.
Ibra is third. Yeah, one season.
Not crazy.
Like, one season.
What do you mean one season? When he was balling at Everton? Shit, he was balling in the Serie A last year before
Everton.
What?
If you were watching the games, he was missing a lot of easy shots. He was scoring the hard shit.
That's what Ibrahimovic does.
He has no touch.
No, I can't accept that
has
anymore.
Has no touch, bro.
I can't accept that anymore. Ibrahimovic has way more of a touch than your favorite striker's favorite striker. Like this, Ibrahimovic has drawn penalties, has taken touches and blown past defenders all year, all this year, all last year. And so
at 39 years fucking old.
This is my New Year's resolution.
Yes, that's why he's not top five, because he's 39 fucking years old. Yes,
he is, because he's still putting in this fucking work. You're wilding.
I will not say that Ibra's not top five, because in the Serie A this year he's played six games and he has 10 goals and one assist. Like, that's pretty nasty for a top striker though he's only played six games, which is kind of interesting, but that's nasty.
What was Ibra doing when he went to the Premier League? What were his stats when he was in the Premier League?
I mean, he had 20 goals that one year before he tore his ACL. Ibra's stats in the Premier League.
He did well for us.
What was that, 16, 17? Let's see. I got you. Ibra's stats in the Premier
League. It had to be 17.
28 games. 28 games, 17 goals, 5 assists. That's pretty top.
Come on, bro.
That's pretty
Come
top.
Come on now.
Hold on.
That's decent. I mean, that's decent for,
that's
I guess,
decent?
The top five strikers.
That's I mean, it's more than decent.
You know what? Hold on. Coming from an Arsenal that is hilarious. Because none of your strikers scored that
Bro,
much.
I was waiting.
Arsenal don't have a striker right now.
I was waiting for when Aubameyang was getting a list. I was waiting for when Aubameyang was going to pop up. But I guess Aubameyang, we're not doing that this year. Okay.
Aubameyang got that check. Now he's on Ozil's level. He's chilling.
Let me blame him? Let me just go
if
through.
If I was on Arsenal too, I'll collect my bread and just chill while y'all Arsenal TV motherfuckers just want to clown us. That's it.
That's true. That's what Ozil's doing. He said, fuck y'all. Y'all can, my heart is still at Arsenal, but y'all can pay me.
Let's, y'all aren't going to give DCL, Dominic Calvert-Lewin any
credit? Hey, Calvert-Lewin. He needs another
we
year.
We talked about him at the beginning of the season.
And he ain't and slowing down.
Boy's up there.
He ain't slowing down.
He's slowed down, but I'll give him top 10.
What? As strikers? I'm not giving him top 10 either. I'm not. Let's not go too far. I can name 10 strikers over him. I would even put Suarez over Calvert-Lewin right now. I got to say, I'm not sold. If I'm a manager and I'm looking up and I only have 20 million to give and somebody's like, you can pay 20 million for Calvert-Lewin or 20 million for Suarez, I'm throwing 20 million at Suarez any day of the year.
That shouldn't even be a question. Or
y'all aren't giving Benzema any.
Benzema's in my top 10, not top 5.
Benzema.
No, the fact that you're a Madrid fan, you know Benzema's not in the top 5. If you can't even.
He's not top 10.
This man, Benzema, forgot all about him. That's right, because we all forgot about Rialo.
You got to start with your own team.
Oh, my God. Because I'm for sure throwing Olivier Giroud.
Yo, stop.
Okay, wait, hold on. Let me just settle out Ibra Lukaku real quick. I'm going back and forth from 2015, okay? Let me just settle the tale. Ibra. 2015, he was playing for PSG. 31 games, 38 goals, 12 assists. Okay?
Well,
Lukaku.
It was PSG, though.
Right.
Keep going.
And Lukaku was playing for United at the time. The Farmers right. League. Lukaku playing for the United at the time. 37 goals, 37 games, 18 goals, 7 assists. And that's at trash United. And you know United was trash that time. 16.
You were just trying to give Zlatan credit for those same, like, similar stats.
Right.
Clearly,
right.
Y'all approve of that stat.
You guys love 17, 18 goals. Next year, we talked about it. His second year, Ibra's second year for United before he tore his ACL. 28 games, 17 goals, 5 assists. Lukaku, his second year, playing on the exact same team. So that's its own kind of issue in itself. He's got 37 games. Oh, shit. Mm-hmm. 37 games, 25 goals, 6 assists. Man, Lukaku. These are his bad years. This is him playing at United. Okay, next. 17, 18, Lukaku. Damn, I didn't even know. Shit, numbers don't lie. I've been saying Lukaku's had bad years at United forever, and it's not even true. 17.
Yo, this is why I don't believe numbers, bro. Because if you watch the fucking games and the nigga is just missing shots left and right, I don't care about the numbers he's scoring. I know what you mean. He's missing.
You know, I can't even argue with that because I like that eye test. I would have bet any amount of money. If somebody said you have $1 million to guess a range of Lukaku's goals for Man United, I'd be like, he averaged about 6 goals a season. That's what I would have for sure said. This man scored 25 goals for United, and people were still shitting on him. 17, 18, Ibra had 22 goals for LA Galaxy in 27 games and 7 assists. 17, 18 for Man United, 34 games, 16 goals, 7 assists. Even in his worst year, he still had 16 goals and 7 assists. Yo, if Ibra's not your top striker, hold on. I'm not even getting to the good part. 18, 19. Is he in the Serie A yet? No, still Premier League. 32 games, 12 goals, 1 assist. This is when you guys start to hate him. That's Lukaku. His last year at United, only 12 goals and 1 assist. And I'm not even going to give you Zlatan's MLS stats because it's just it's a waste of my time. We'll wait till he gets back to the Serie A.
Yep.
Lukaku, first year for Inter, 36 games, 23 goals, 2 assists. 51 games overall, 34 goals, 6 assists. How is that not a top 5 striker? Zlatan, let's get his first year at Milan. He just he got there mid-year, right? So he only played 18 goals.
Second half.
18 games, 10 goals, 5 assists, which is, I mean, for 18 games, that's still pretty. I mean, let's not get it twisted. Ibra is in his own category, and Ibra's the god, the legend, and I will even say he's top 5 striker right now. But he's not on top of Lukaku. I can't do it. 51 games, 34 goals.
On your team, you pick Lukaku? Like,
well, we've named way more people than 5, so someone can be in the top 5.
All right, give me your 5. I want your 5. Because I'm going to defenders next.
Ashko.
Yeah.
Lewandowski, cannot deny that.
Can't deny that.
Harry Kane.
You can deny it, but whatever. I haven't looked up his stats.
Harry Kane. I'm going to go with Lukaku. Benzema. Probably going to go with Jamie Vardy. Top five.
Jamie Vardy is such a sleeper, but I just...
And am I, what's the young boy out of Dortmund? I mean, he is balling.
Oh, I don't know necessarily.
I
put him top five actually.
I mean, he is a baller. I mean, he's young, but
he's too young.
The man can do a lot.
Are we not including Mbappe into the striker conversation? Is he not a striker?
That's tough. He's a forward for me.
Okay. I mean, yeah, he's a forward.
I mean, you got to pick like Icardi or Cavani or right. One of those guys they had running around in the center.
Right. Yeah. No, I'll give you that. He's a forward. Man, Vardy is the only one I would argue on your.
I would probably switch him out with Haaland. I would be comfortable doing that.
But I don't know if Haaland's much better. If you were fielding a team for 1 year and 1 year only, so age wasn't a factor. It was just, you know, a player who can play. Are you picking Vardy or are you picking Haaland? I'm picking Vardy.
I think I can pick Haaland. I'd pick Haaland. From the type of goals he scored, they are very different goals.
They're very.
And they are all like
header, speed, shot.
Weak-footed shots.
Yeah,
shot. They are aggressive as fuck goals. They are bullets.
No, that's real. That's real. That's tough.
But no age, then now you know shit. Now we're got it to think about, like you said, Suarez, Aguero. Them niggas were ballers in their primes back in the day.
Yeah, Aguero almost like a guilty inadmission because he's just not been around. You know, like who knows if he has been playing all year this year, would we not be like, bro, Aguero, easily. You know what I mean? All you would have to do is score like five goals to be that. That's tough.
I don't even know who City's top striker is right now. I mean, I don't even know how they're getting
City doesn't goals. Have a top striker. What's City on the table right now? City's like seventh or eighth?
Eighth.
Yeah. Like,
I think De Bruyne is their top goal scorer.
It's definitely Sterling. It's definitely Sterling still. It's got to be.
Is it? Look it up.
I think Sterling.
Drum roll. I think it's probably Sterling. Yeah. It's Sterling and De Bruyne.
It's De Bruyne. I think De Bruyne has a more assist.
Oh, for sure, De Bruyne has more assists.
Yo.
I mean, yeah, he's
yo, goals, what?
Oh, De Bruyne more?
It is. This is so crazy. Does this?
Gabriel Jesus.
No way.
It's not Gabriel Jesus.
They don't even have somebody on the top 10, do they?
It is Riyad Mahrez.
What? You're lying.
It is Riyad Mahrez and okay, Raheem Sterling is tied with him.
They're tied for four goals each this season. Sterling get like three in the first four games?
Dog. City has really taken a dive, dude. They're not missing outside of Aguero, they're not missing any pieces. This is the same team basically as last year. You know, like
add new players.
We got a new defender.
They got a new defender. But that's not affecting goal scorers. And if anything, they should be scoring more goals because De Bruyne was hurt all last season. Or for most of last season. Like this team is just Pep's system is like not working anymore. I think Klopp usurped
I feel
him.
Like they're just mentally defeated. I think like after that Champions League loss a few months ago, like I just think they're just mentally just, we don't know what the fuck is going on. Right. Do we still believe in the system?
Does this make sense? Yeah. Tough, man. How do you break a team up like this though? Like, I mean, if you were De Bruyne, would you give it one more year and then just make a move?
Either you inject new blood, you know, maybe Messi is that missing piece to unlock them, right? Or, you've got to just kind of spin out some of those parts, try to sell De Bruyne or whomever it may be to really try and bring in some new blood.
Damn. That is...
They need another midfielder to compete with De Bruyne. I feel like De Bruyne plays great, but if someone was to, like, be at his heels, right? Or, like, just even replace him and give him a break, because maybe he's just tired too, right? Like, I mean, the guy turns so red during games. Like,
he always turns it. Like fast 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Come on now, you know it's just his complexion.
I don't know, man. That's too. That's redder than I've ever seen anyone.
Bro, he is like the most ginger. Like.
I would say, you know, I'm a big fan of Sterling. But I will always say you cannot rely on that man to lead your team. You need a top striker. Gabriel Jesus just is not a top striker.
Facts.
Aguero is a top striker, but the man is just injured. He's older now. They should have brought in a guy that gets fucking goals. They should have brought in Haaland, honestly.
Yeah.
A young, hungry kid that's willing to do a lot.
Yeah. Yeah. No, I agree.
They brought in all these midfield players that make you fucking dizzy.
They do make you dizzy. They're just the same. But, you know, it's funny. Klopp does the same thing. So why is it working for Klopp, but it's not working? Klopp does not have a top striker. Though you've heard me say it on this podcast so many times that Bobby Firmino is like the most underrated, important piece to that team. Like, they don't got a top striker. Bobby Firmino's got less than 5 goals this year. So like,
I think it's definitely below 5.
It's definitely below 5. So
how many goals he had last season? Firmino.
That's good
last season.
This
like 14.
But to your point, though, you need to have forwards or strikers. I don't care what you call them, attackers who are just competing constantly to get goal, like aggressively. Who wants the ball to put that ball in the back of the net? If I look at that Man City team, I don't know who I'm giving the ball to. Sterling could be kicking the ball over the bar, missing it. Who knows where it's going? They just don't have anyone that's that aggressive.
Yeah.
What are you gonna do? You're gonna put what's Phil Foden? Is he your center fucking forward?
No. But I will say, to your point, Juan, De Bruyne has 7 assists in 13 games. De Bruyne doesn't need any pepping up. He's doing his fucking thing. And I'm pretty sure if Sterling and Gabby Jesus most likely, and shit, even Riyad were, you know, doing more and finishing more, he'd have more assists and City would be doing well. So there's something else missing. I think you're right, but I don't think it's in the midfield. They need strikers to be competing with strikers to be putting that shit in the net.
Yeah.
You know, maybe they need like to do a Barca and grab like a Braithwaite or some, you know, or grab some, you know, Serie A Brazil player. Shit. Yeah. Jamie Vardy, maybe, you know, who knows? Vardy's never leaving Leicester. Like, that man is loyal to the bone.
Yeah, they need someone that's just locked in on goal all day long.
Right. You need an Inzaghi type.
A true striker.
I don't even know if there are those type of players out there anymore who are just like, no, I don't do anything but camp out and wait for my chance to put it in the goal. Like, almost even like a Robert Van Persie. You never see Robert Van Persie highlights where he's just like, you know, step overs in the middle of the field and, you know, like running past. No. You go to Google right now and type in RVP highlights. It is like diving headers, one touch volley shots from right outside the box. You know, like that's what that guy is. That's what, you know, I don't think there's.
They don't make RVPs anymore.
They don't make RVPs.
He was rare air.
By the way, Yohei,
I actually knew what a striker was.
It's tough that we're like losing him, and that's why I talk about him so much. Yohei, Bobby Firmino had 9 goals in 38 games last year for Liverpool. And I will also say, Dale mentioned the Brazilian curse, talking about, you know, Brazilians who get, you know, once they get past 29 years old, they won't go higher. In 13 games, I think in less than 13 games, he has 5 goals this year. So if he just scores 4 more goals, Bobby for this year, Bobby Firmino's broken the Brazilian curse. So just keep an eye out on that. That's something. Top 5 midfielders of the year, boy.
So sorry, when you say top midfielders, are you talking like, you know,
I'm
defensive? Like, obviously De Bruyne has got to be in there.
De Bruyne has got to be in there, but also maybe a Casemiro. Like, do we need to separate defensive midfielders from attacking midfielders? And
are there enough defensive midfielders to name?
That's what I mean. No. So just give me your most effective midfielders, period. Defensive to attacking to box. Give me your top 5 midfielders, period, for the year. You want me to go?
De Bruyne, Bruno Fernandes, Casemiro. Could I throw Thomas Muller in there?
No. He's a forward.
He's a forward
for sure. He's a forward and winger. Shit. Yeah. but he's not a midfielder. You better throw motherfucking Conte in there. I don't give a fuck what y'all are thinking.
Nah, yeah.
If N'Golo Conte is not in your top five.
For sure. He's a workhorse.
He's absolutely in every team I would ever field if I had an option. 100% N'Golo Conte. There's a lot of midfielders, though. You guys are really looking up to the heavens.
Talk about midfielders that explain the stats, but I might have to go with, I'm just going to always throw Pogba in my midfield.
I'll just
take that chance.
I love Pogba, but over the course of 2020, I'll go
with the France Pogba.
Yeah, but France hadn't been playing this year. I'm talking about this year, 2020. Do you want injured and in the news Pogba on your team right now? Because that's been the majority of 2020 for Pogba.
Ash.
Yeah.
You still haven't watched All or Nothing.
Which one?
The Tottenham? I still have not.
Because you wouldn't say Pogba's name if you watched it.
Not true. Not true. Wait, which All or Nothing?
The Tottenham one?
Yeah. What? Seeing the type of coach Jose Mourinho is.
Ah.
Pogba's a diva, bro.
No, I won't even give you that. I won't even give you that.
There was a game. No. Hold on a second.
Yes.
He said Pogba is going to tear this shit up.
Yes.
And what did Pogba do?
He came on in the 70th minute and tore them up. I agree with that. That's why I said All or Nothing. Yohei, I think you watched All or Nothing. I don't know if you did, Yohei, but there's a part in the Tottenham All or Nothing documentary where Jose is coaching his team and they played I'm telling you, it's a fun watch. It's like it's super interesting, and they cut it off. I wonder if they brought it back because they cut it off obviously because of COVID halfway through the season. But I wonder if they're bringing it back. But there's a section in the show where Tottenham faces up Man United, and I think it's a game that they end up winning like 2-1 or maybe they tie 2-2. But literally at halftime, Jose brings his team in for a talk, and he looks at everybody and he goes, they are going to bring on Pogba. When he comes on, I kid you not, he is going to get a ball and play it 50 yards diagonal to a Rashford or a Martial running. And there's a clip on Instagram that I will find for you that literally dictates this exactly what Jose predicted happened. So regardless of whatever issues they had at Man United together and Pogba being a diva, Jose Mourinho knows that Pogba is that guy because he said, watch the fuck out. And guess what happened? Pogba gets the ball, turns, and serves a fucking 50, 60-yard diagonal into stride into Rashford. And Rashford takes an amazing first touch, and then he blows the fucking shot. That should have been a goal. But, like, he tears defenses to pieces. That said, he's not in my top five for the year 2020, unfortunately. And you know what? 2020's been a bad year. So, I don't know.
How about Bruno Fernandes?
Yeah, Bruno.
Bruno, yeah, he has to be, right? He has to be. Man United was absolute trash, and now they're like a little, now they're like recycling, you know, like they're a little bit better. And that's all because of Bruno. So I'll give it to Bruno for sure. I'll give it to Bruno for sure. What about Thiago, even though he hasn't been playing for Liverpool thus far? But what he's done with Bayern.
His first game was amazing.
With Bayern, for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
His first game, and you're right, his first game was amazing. I mean, shit, the whole Bayern midfield, like, Kimmich could easily be top five midfielders.
Kimmich is top five. He's top five because he's in Europa's top like, five.
We didn't talk about that either.
He balls out.
Like, how random were the best awards this year? The FIFA, did y'all even catch those?
Yeah.
So midfielders, Thiago, Kevin De Bruyne, and Kimmich. That was FIFA Pro's best.
Yeah.
Pogba, I might not put in there. Conte is a definite for me. I'm not really, I guess, Thiago. I guess, you know, it's just so tough, man. Bayern just play. I mean, people talk about Paris. I mean, about France being a farmers league. Is Germany a farmers league? Like, is anybody watching Bundesliga consistently? None of y'all. I mean, let me ask it this way. Since none of y'all's supporting teams are in the Bundesliga, are y'all still watching Bundesliga?
Yeah, I watch Dortmund. I like Dortmund. But they've been slacking the last couple weeks.
Yeah. So that's a no, basically, because you're watching Dortmund. You're not watching Bayern. So you're not even watching the best team in the Bundesliga, which means that's just not a fun league to watch. Like,
that's boring.
Because I'm going to be real with you. Up until probably really recently, I never missed a Madrid or Barca game. I've been missing them lately because ain't nothing fun to see over there. Like, I put Casemiro in off of GP, but like, I don't think Casemiro's top five even right now. Obviously we went around the horn and Benzema only came up once and he doesn't seem top five. Ramos is probably the only player on Madrid right now who can make a top five spot in any of y'all's brackets.
That's because they're not playing well.
I don't know what it is though. That's another team that's got, I mean, they got a lot of young boys on their team, but you got a four-time Champions League winning core midfield and Casemiro. I don't know what's up with Valverde. He was balling last year.
Where are my Tony Cruz fans at?
Dog.
Oh, I like him.
You like Tony Cruz still? If you were to replace...
I like Modric better. But
yeah, exactly.
Yeah, I like Tony Cruz.
If you were to replace any midfielder in your team right now, Yohei, who would it be and who would it be with?
Wow.
I know, that's kind of like...
Honestly, I replace Toni Kroos with Kevin De Bruyne.
There it is. Facts. Yo, you heard it here. All you Toni Kroos fans, it was cool. Go watch his documentary. Happy for his four Champions Leagues or five because he got one with Bayern. Or maybe it's four with Bayern and three with Madrid. Whatever. But Toni, we're done. Toni, you're done. De Bruyne, we got new. There's new kids in town. Defenders, top five. And this is wing backs and center backs. And shit, there ain't a lot of center backs out there. So your top five will probably be four.
Alexander Arnold.
Yeah, Alexander Arnold.
He's kind of bad this season, though.
I mean, he's still.
He's good.
He's bombing those assists down the flanks, man.
He is bombing those assists, but I don't even know if he's starting for England. Like that's you know what I mean? Like Trippier could easily get up there over him. Who's the other right back? There's another English right back that I'm not thinking of. Oh, Juan Bissaka.
Walker.
Shit, even
oh.
Kyle Walker. Nah, bro. Kyle Walker's past his point, bro. Again, we just talked about Man City. Kyle Walker's a huge contributor to why they're playing so poorly. It's unfortunate.
Yeah.
But Juan Bissaka.
I think I said that though. Like. Yeah, dude.
Yeah.
Kyle Walker sucks.
Okay, I didn't go that far. You see, y'all be taking shit so far.
So many errors, man. It's like a big contributor to, like...
I think about center backs, though.
And then they don't, you know, they can't do anything about it. Who's available?
I mean, they don't have anybody available, but that's poor management. Like, Pep brought in Mendy. He brought in Kyle Walker. You know, they could never get their center backs right. John Stones is always injured somehow. You know, they had Otamendi. They brought Fernandinho back. Like, they just don't know what they're doing defensively, and that's probably contributing to their issues. Whereas Klopp, who kind of runs the same system, but except it's less passy-passy and more, like, direct, you know, he's got some fucking – he's got probably the best defense pound for pound in the world, you know, with the two wingbacks who can easily make a World 11 team. And Virgil van Dijk, who, you know, like, you know, was declining before his injury, but he'll be back. And then Gomez, who's kind of underrated. I keep hearing stuff I literally heard Jordan Henderson and Andy Robertson say that Andre Gomez is one of the fastest people on the team, which I would have never believed. But,
oh.
I mean, yeah. So, I don't know. All right, my defenders, I'm going definitely Alexander Arnold. I'm going Alphonso Davies. I'm going...
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. I'm going... Okay. We're going top five, right? I'm obviously going Sergio Ramos and Virgil van Dijk, you know, because he only got injured this year. You know, he's still top of the top. So, that's four. And my fifth defender would probably be... Damn, like I wanted to do Upamecano at Leipzig, but he only had one really great game. But I want to do somebody like that. I also, you know, like I low-key want to do Kimpembe. Like he is a defender on a team that plays zero defense. Like, nobody on that team plays defense. You got Verratti and whoever floating around in that midfield not playing any fucking defense. You got the wingbacks that go so far up. It is literally Kimpembe and Marquinhos in the backfield. Yeah. And they pretty much hold it down. They've got, you know, got Neymar's squad to a Champions League final. So I think I low-key might put Kimpembe in my top five of defenders just for that. And for that post I sent you where last weekend he was on a 4-on-1 and he ends up tackling the ball away. That was pretty impressive too. But yeah, I'm that's me. Alexander Arnold, Davies, Van Dijk, Ramos, Kimpembe. Y'all are like, we don't care about defenders. Y'all even want to do keepers? Y'all want to do keepers? Nobody can even.
Alisson.
Man, I feel like I haven't even seen Alisson play too much this year.
Guys, Ter Stegen.
Ter Stegen.
That is the defense of Barca. It's a terrible defense, right? Watch Ter Stegen's blocks, bro.
Ter Stegen is amazing. He's amazing.
So good.
I think he's better than Neuer.
Yeah, for sure.
100%. That's what I told.
But they blackball him, bro, because he doesn't play in Germany.
Yeah. What was it? That 8? When did they lost 8-1, right?
Yeah.
After that game, that's when he lost his starting position, which is bullshit.
Well, Neuer was hurt anyway, so it was bound to happen that Neuer would come back and.
I mean, even last World Cup, that Neuer, like, whole time, he didn't play whole season.
Mm-hmm.
And then Ter Stegen played amazing that season.
Yep.
And then that guy, the coach picked Neuer over Ter Stegen. That's bullshit.
Yeah.
And honestly, that's why Germany not doing too well these days.
Yeah.
I think so, too.
Yeah, that was ugly. Who did they get bossed out by?
Spain.
Spain dragged them. It was 8-1. Spain. That's what it was.
Yes. Yeah. Spain washed. I think it was like 6-1.
Damn.
8-1 was.
Yeah,
6-1. 8-1 was Bayern versus Barca in the Champions League semi.
Oh, that's right. That's right.
Yo, Juan, fix your face, all right?
Juan doesn't even care. Juan's over this Barcelona team anyway. He's waiting. He's waiting for Messi to leave.
Yo, you think Messi leaving, bro?
I want to rebuild. I think he should leave. And I want to rebuild. I want Barcelona to go through like a real rebuild. I mean, you know.
What does that look like?
You don't see it happen that often. What does that look like?
Yeah, is that like Ansu Fati and Ronald Koeman just bringing in a bunch of young boys like that? Or is that? I mean, they have a core: De Jong, Fati, Dembele, if he stays.
They pick up the right. They pick up the right from Juventus. They just start young. They start young. They go together. They go together. Like 4 years, we have a Champions League team.
Okay.
Like a real Champions League team.
So you're ready to see Messi go?
Yeah. They were learning too much on him when he plays.
Yeah.
Like Argentina does the same thing. Any team that has Messi, for whatever reason, does the same thing. Except, I think that if he's on Pep's team, Pep knows how to work with Messi, and Pep will be like, "Look, man, the ball's not going to go through you, but we're going to win."
I don't think I saw that when Pep was. Well, I guess it was because he had Iniesta and Xavi and all the rest of those boys.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
Yeah. Also, honorable mention to Alvaro Morata for the strikers, because, you know, that man bounces around everywhere. But he went ham in that game when they dragged Germany. He's been doing well in scoring goals and playing his role on Juve. I think he deserves an honorable mention to somewhere. That's all I have to say.
I think Memphis Depay deserves an honorable mention.
Yeah. I'm with that.
Agreed.
I'm wondering if he's heading over to Barcelona next season.
That's a possibility.
Would you take him?
Yeah. I mean, if Messi leaves, I think players like him would be essential, right? Because he's still young-ish, right? What is he, 26, 27?
He's 26. Damn, he's young.
Okay.
Yeah, that's how long he's been around.
Yeah, he's been around for a while.
He's been around for a long time. He was the next GOAT. You guys remember that talk?
I told George that last. We were talking to George about that last show, bro. George was like, "Memphis did fine at United. Memphis was chilling at United." We look at Memphis stats. He had like 2 goals in 50 games or some shit.
No, I loved it, man. Shit.
I love Depay, and honestly, like, you know, we've seen a lot of great ACL tear recoveries, you know, within the past 5-10 years, but I don't think I've seen a better one than Memphis. Like, I forgot he tore his ACL, and literally, I think 2 days ago he posted about it, was his 1 year anniversary of his surgery. That was
on the bed.
Yeah, he was on the hospital bed. Yeah. Literally 1 year ago, he just finished ACL surgery, and he's scored at least 20 something goals since then. Like, it's been pretty crazy for him. So I don't know. Yeah, I give you that honorable mention, Memphis.
Or like Martial to Barcelona. I think someone else could get more out of Martial.
Yes, I agree. Yes, I agree. No, I don't know who.
Martial at Barca would be good.
Martial scored a great goal. Martial at Barca, really?
You don't think so?
Just go young, man. I just think they need to go young. They need to stop trying to be contenders right now.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah. Go young. Go Ansu Fati and like play within their formula. The only thing is, I just don't think Martial fits that formula. I think Martial fits like a. Like.
Madrid.
Yeah. Yes. Yes. Like, I would replace low key Vinicius with Martial, or even Benzema.
Oh yeah. Yeah. I'll do that.
And George and I have talked about this. Like, Martial, the way Martial goes and attacks defenders and terrorizes defenders, I don't see that out of a lot of players. And like, that's a mentality. That's a mentality you have to have on one of those killer teams. And not that Barcelona is not a killer team, but Barcelona is more methodical. Like, They come in, like, people are so afraid of Barcelona that Barcelona can literally come in and just pass and pass and pass around. And the issue is that, like, that passing game is now, you know, you kind of see the game go in waves. And, you know, the time of tiki-taka is not in session right now, bro. Like, it is direct ball. That is, like, you can see it from Liverpool. The way to get goals is to launch that ball up and launch it across the goal and see if you can deflect it in goal somehow. So, yeah, Barca definitely need a little bit of a makeover. Definitely. For keepers, I'm definitely putting Jordan Pickford in there just because because Everton's balling. Ancelotti seems to have really figured shit out with them, and they're not necessarily scoring the most goals, which means, honestly, just because they passed, because of the eye test, man, like, that man, I'm seeing him save some crazy goals. Shit. I saw him just save one against Arsenal. They were beating Arsenal like 92nd minute. Aubameyang had an opportunity and Pickford fucking one-handed that shit away. So he's in my top five. I'm putting Allison just off GP. He hasn't really done shit this year, but he's Allison. So, you know, like, you know, I can't keep him out. You know, I guess I'll have to put Neuer there because shit, he's man's winning Champions League still. And he's like the top, you know, top keeper on that Bayern team. Who's essentially the best team in the world. Would love to see Bayern play Liverpool. That'd be an interesting game. Who else am I throwing up there? I want to throw Ederson up there, bro, but his net has just been getting busted this year. He's just been getting scored on. Jan Oblak is always a big baller, but Atletico also just don't seem like it. You know who I'm going to put in my fucking top five, though? Fuck it. Like, fuck it. If we're throwing Ibra in there, I'm putting Gigi Buffon in there. Gigi Buffon.
Yeah, Gigi's been balling.
Bro, he has been balling. Anytime he's called on, he comes in and balls. That game against Barca, when Juve played Barca, yo, like, as great as Cristiano played, shit, Weston McKennie even played, Aaron Ramsey. Gigi was back there saving. Like, he kept that clean sheet.
He was.
That man is 40 years old. So that's top, you know, what? That's four for me. And, yeah.
Did you see the picture? The Messi pulled the Gigi Buffon's jersey like this, and then they exchanged the jerseys after the game. So, like, Messi's like, I think he showed, like, 7 times. And then Buffon stopped everything.
Wait, every fucking time. And then he just gave him a shit. I would have probably been like, sign this shit, man. Like, just sign it. Yeah, maybe. Two legends.
He got it.
Two full legends. Gigi is for sure a legend. You know, I would be really interested. I don't think Juve can do it, but I would love to see Cristiano and Gigi and shit Weston McKennie get a fucking Champions League win this year. That would be, or next year, I guess. That would be really dope.
Would he be the first American to win the Champions League?
Has any American? I guess I think so. I don't think any American has been on a Champions League.
Yeah, where didn't? Where was Tim Howard when Man U were won?
No, he wasn't on the squad.
Everton.
Yeah,
he went back to Everton.
He yeah.
Damn, it was like he was the on season Everton before, huh?
Yeah, I think he just missed out.
Yo, fact check mode and supreme effect. Jovan Karavsky from Escondido, California is an American soccer player who is the only American to win the UEFA's Champions League and first to score in a Champions League match.
What team was he on?
What is his name? He won it at Dortmund,
97. Did Dortmund win? Okay, Dortmund won at 97. Wow. So there you go.
I think they won.
Jovan Karavsky. All right. Anyway, that's a very interesting. Damn, that would have been a good trivia question. Yo, I got three trivia questions for you to close it out for the end of the year. All right. I don't know how we can do this. One, you know what I'm going to do? Do y'all have a pen and paper handy?
No.
All right. For the ones who don't have a pen and paper handy, you can use the chat function in this group chat we're on. And if you do have a pen and paper handy, just use the write these answers down. I'm gonna ask three questions. You only get one opportunity to write one answer. Don't Google anything. You just look at them. They're over there like looking for paper. You know what you can do? Also do
writing it in notes.
Put it in your notes. Put it on your phone. Type it in your notes, and then you have to hold it up to the camera. Or what you can do is you can text me. Text me your answers, and then we'll do it from there. Are we ready?
Let's do it.
Is it harder than shit in here?
No.
If it gets too hot, just close that.
Okay.
It's really hot in here, but
for sure. Yeah. It's puffing.
Yeah. What is going on?
What is going on?
What are you phoning a friend? No. Might as well introduce this person now.
No, it's my girlfriend's mom.
Oh, bring her on. Does she like soccer?
No, she hates it.
Ooh, good. Damn.
Good, we can ask her why she hates it. Let's make a fan.
True. Okay.
All right, boys, we're ready. It's the last questions of the year for the Eat, Pray, Ball podcast. You have five and five only questions to answer. The person who gets the best accumulated answers wins a amazing prize at the end of this. I'm gonna turn this music down because that is just loud and annoying. All right, question number one. So what you're gonna do is you're just gonna write them down and I'm gonna keep rattling off questions until we get through the five, all right? Question number one. Which MLS team won the MLS Cup this year? Which MLS team was at no Googling, George, no Googling. No, I'm just playing. I'm just playing. All right. Write that down. Question number two is what player has scored the most goals in the 2020 calendar year in Europe's top five leagues? Which player has scored the most goals for their team in their league in Europe's top five leagues throughout 2020? All right. Question number three. What MLS team? You like how I'm throwing MLS. We never talk about MLS, and that is something I'm planning to do. We never. What MLS team is currently still in the Champions League? We only have one MLS team still currently in the CONCACAF Champions League. What team is this? Number four. What Premier League manager said this quote? I cannot say what I think. I will be suspended. That's it. That's a tough one. Premier League manager.
Run that question back. You cut out. What did you say?
What Premier League manager said this quote when referring to referring to officials talking about VAR? I cannot say what I think because I will be suspended. I cannot say what I think because I will be suspended. All right. Last question. What current Premier League player playing now has scored the most goals in the Premier League? What current Premier League player has scored the most goals out of anybody playing right now in the Premier League? Rump, da-dump, dump, 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 dump. All right. It's time to turn in your answers, boys. Let me do this. George, you put yours in the chat, right?
Yeah.
So I will say yours last. Ash, go ahead and text your answer. Text your notes to me. And we'll start with Yohei and Juan. All right, so George is yours here. All right, Yohei, for the question, who won the MLS Cup? Who did you put?
Dude, you gotta repeat that. My mom called.
Oh, sorry. Both of you for both of you. You got us both. What are you in your mom's basement? Meatloaf. Meatloaf. God damn it! All right, both of you, Yohei and Juan, for the question of who won the MLS Cup, what did you get?
Seattle.
Both of you put Seattle?
Yeah.
Yo, cheating?
That is right. At least you guys knew.
Yes, got one right.
At least you guys knew who was in the final. That is incorrect.
Columbus, isn't it?
It is the Columbus Crew beat Seattle 3-0.
Damn.
Oh, tough.
Damn. That's why I didn't hear about it.
What did you put? Oh, George put Seattle too. George put Seattle. AJ is in the lead with 1 point. He put the Columbus Crew. There we go. We got some MLS knowledge on this podcast on the Eat Pray Ball.
Damn.
Yohei won for question number two. Who has the most goals in the calendar year? This year for their leagues and Europe's top five leagues, who'd you put?
Lewandowski.
Who'd you put, Juan?
I put Salah.
Salah, Lewandowski, George put Louis, as well as AJ, and I'm here to tell you, you are all incorrect. As for the calendar year of 2020, it is in fact a Cristiano Ronaldo who has the most goals in the league. In his league.
Wow.
With 29 goals.
Wait a minute. You said top goal scorer.
In the calendar year.
Including Champions League.
No. In the Europe's top five leagues. In the league. Who do you got?
No, you didn't specify in the league.
Look at him, dude.
Would you have gotten Cristiano anyway? Would you have ever put Cristiano? No.
I might have. It was a different question. I would have thought if I knew the right fucking question.
I mean, you all did put Lewandowski. I can't be mad at you, but did I not specify Europe's top five league? And either way.
You said Europe's top five leagues. Who was the top goal scorer? Period.
All right. You know what?
You didn't say in their respective league, in the top five leagues, who's the top goal scorer? That's a different question.
I'm going to put Lewandowski 2020 calendar year goals. And if he has not in Champions League too, if he doesn't have as many as Cristiano, then you're just out. You're just out the whole game. You have no, and you're up a point.
I'll take it.
And you're up a fucking point. All right. Hold on. Let's get through the rest of this and then we'll go back. We'll circle back to that. All right. Question number four. Question number three is who is the surviving MLS team in the CONCACAF Champions League? Who did you put, Juan?
LAFC.
Same. I didn't cheat.
He didn't cheat.
I didn't cheat.
AJ had Ash got LAFC too. Damn, George, you are 0-3 right now with Orlando FC. That was a good try. Actually, it wasn't. They're nowhere near the CONCACAF Champions League. You would have been better saying Atlanta or something. That is where we are. As for the very, very like random quote, question number four, who said, I cannot speak about this, I will be suspended in regards in when referring to the refs and VAR? Who said that, Yohei?
Mourinho? No?
Who'd you put, Juan? Let me see. George is on the board, too. All of y'all got Jose Mourinho for that answer. Good job. Who else gets quoted in fucking Premier League other than Mourinho? All right. Last question. Who is the leading goal scorer in the Prem who is a still active player? What did you guys say?
What are these little caveats? What does that mean? Who's still an active player? Like what? An inactive player?
What player currently playing? Didn't I say this as the question? What player currently playing has the most Premier League goals?
This season, right?
No.
Of all time. All time.
Ever.
Yeah, currently playing, and it's Aguero.
There it is. Yo, hey. You put who? You put Aguero?
You needed to type over those questions. Fucking service. That's bullshit.
Who did you put? Hold on. Ash put Mohamed Salah. Mad as shit. This man. George put Jermaine Defoe. I don't even know Jermaine Defoe is. Is Jermaine Defoe still alive? Shit.
Yo, I swear he's still playing.
Jermaine Defoe be getting goals, though. Bro, Jermaine Defoe be getting goals.
I swear he's still playing, bro.
I wonder where he is on the top five list. I mean, on the all-time list, honestly. Bro, he's number eight. Jermaine Defoe. If Jermaine Defoe was still playing, he would be number two on the list to Sergio Aguero. So, yeah, that's actually not a bad answer. All right. Do you really want me to look in through this Lewandowski? You want to look through all goals 2020?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Okay. All right. I got Lewandowski's numbers. Let me see if Cristiano... We're talking about all goals, right?
All goals. What's the answer?
It is still Chris. Well, technically, it is Lionel Messi. Technically.
Ooh.
With 47 goals.
How's that possible?
But Cristiano is still usurping Lewandowski with 44 goals because it's club and country. And Champions League and all the above. So unfortunately, Ash, that Lewandowski answer will not be accepted. However,
hey, you know what? Next time, whoever loses should be the one that picks the questions. We need to get Matt involved in this. This man's just talking shit as a fucking moderator.
I just moderate, baby. I don't answer questions. I just do my thug thizzle. Well, shit. Boys, it is the last pot of the year. I appreciate y'all coming in with me and bringing a close to 2020. We're going nowhere but up for 2021. January 10th, Sunday, January 10th, we are back in action. Bless up. 2021, we're on our way. It's the Eat, Pray, Ball podcast, and we are out of here. All right, boys.